Hello, welcome back to another tutorial. My name is Xander. This is the Nginx Mastery series. In the previous tutorial, we started to talk about access restrictions, and we created an endpoint or location, and then we protected that via a username and password. If you haven't seen the previous tutorials in this series, then just head over to the main channel, go to the playlist, and have a look for the Nginx Mastery series, and there you'll find the previous tutorials in this series. In this tutorial, I wanted just to lay down the foundation, the underpinning knowledge on how to configure access to resources, restricting or allowing access based upon IP addresses. For this tutorial, you will find a timeline, because if you have seen the previous tutorial, you don't need to go through the setup here, which I'm just about to explain. So use the timeline in the video description to go over to where I start to talk about protecting via IP address. So you will find a link in the video description, which will take you over to the Nginx Mastery series. Now, a quick setup here. We're going to download part 9 and quickly set that up so we can then start to apply IP address restrictions. So go ahead and download the repository and open up part 9 in Visual Studio Code, and I'll take you through the next steps. So now we have the part 9 downloaded. I've opened this up in Visual Studio Code. A few things to get this started. Now, you are going to need Docker Desktop installed. Apologies if I didn't mention earlier. This all works within Docker. So to get this working, we need to still create our folder for the environment folder here, the .env. And I'm just creating a new file here called, I always forget what this is called. I think it's dev.env, and then inside of here we're going to need some environment variables. So simply put, there we go. So that's just some environment variables, sorry, that Django is going to require. So irrelevant for this tutorial, but that just gets things nicely set up. So in addition to that, I think we're good to go. So there are some commands here if you're not familiar to this series to help you get started, and the commands that I generally use inside of the tutorials here. One of them is this here. We're going to need this to create a username and password. Now, that's not necessarily required here to showcase IP address security, but we'll get things started if you are new to this series, just to familiarize yourself. So ensuring that Docker is installed, Docker Desktop. So I'll go ahead and open up Docker Desktop. So here I'm completely working on a clean slate, so there's nothing in containers or images. So let's go ahead and run Docker Compose up. That's going to build the containers, or the images and the containers, start the containers. So everything is running nicely at this point. So we can test this. Let's just open up 127. So we are just going to need the loopback address. There's no requirement for ports here. Looks like everything is working okay. So we're going to be utilizing this test page. You can see at the moment it is forbidden because you need a username and password. I think that is the case. So we may as well go ahead. I guess it's just a recap of the previous tutorial. Let's go ahead. Here I'm using Docker extension. So let's go in and attach a shell so we can work within the container. And like you saw earlier, we have some commands here, and this allows us to configure a password for this user. So I'm just going to put the password as user1, type in user1 twice. So that's the password now sorted. So let's just go back here. And now I'm asked if I refresh for username and password. So user1, there we go. So that's what we did in the previous tutorial. That's what we set up. We had a username and password. So now let's talk about IP addresses. So like I alluded to earlier, this is really just a baseline, the start of a longer journey potentially utilizing IP addresses in our configuration. So let's just go through the basics here of using IP addresses to restrict access to a location. So if you go into Nginx folder, open up your default config. Now, the one thing that may be a little bit confusing, in the actual Nginx documentation, I think it referenced the fact that IP address configurations here would be conducted within a stream or server block. It doesn't necessarily specify, maybe just an oversight. It doesn't necessarily specify the fact that you can also use it within a location block. It just specifies a stream and server block. So it would be worth noting that obviously, if we'd put an IP address limit here on the server block, it would then refer to all of the locations potentially, whereas that's not necessarily something that you want to apply. Maybe it is, of course, in which case that's where we're going to start our configuration inside of our server block. But we can also configure IP access inside of our location blocks. So the premise of this is very simple. Everyone has an IP address. In general terms, everyone on the internet will have an IP address. And the idea here is that we're trying to restrict access to maybe a location or multiple locations based upon the user's IP address. Now, of course, the reality of this is it's very easy to change your IP address or use other IP addresses online to make it look as though you're not the person potentially that's trying to be restricted. You know, when we start to think about using proxy servers and so on, it's very easy to restrict or hide your IP address. So I say proxy server, a VPN or proxy server. So you may already be familiar with a VPN, a virtual private network, maybe from, for example, ExpressVPN or Surfshark. The idea is that you pay for a service and essentially your IP address, your internet IP address, is changed to maybe a geographical location which you're trying to access different services within. And that obviously allows you to protect or hide your real IP address. So that is something that's kind of out of the scope of this tutorial. I'm not trying to kind of delve into how to overcome those type of issues. We simply want to learn here how to actually apply or restrict, sorry, allow or deny IP addresses to certain locations. So now I've said too much, let's just talk about restricting access by IP address. Okay, so Nginx then can allow or deny access based on a particular IP address. And this is something, again, we can talk about security and layers, because here we have a location here which has a username and password authentication. And we can then buddy that up also with IP addresses. And here you can start to see this idea of security layers. Now, this is really straightforward and simple, because here in Nginx, we simply have two directives, allow or deny. And it is really as simple as that in basic terms. So here I can basically say deny, and then I can define what I want to deny. So a few things that I can deny here, or a few different formats I can utilize here. I can use words such as or, which describes the fact that I'm now going to deny everyone access to any of these locations. So let's just put that in place. And we're going to need to restart the server. So what I'll do is I'll just create a new shell, and I'll do this slightly different this time. Normally I just restart the container. That will also then pick up the new configuration, but we can also just go into the container, type in Nginx and reload. So that's just going to reload the configuration. So let's go back here. Now we're on the same page, so we just go and refresh, and you can now see we get a forbidden. So we're not asked to actually enter a username and password anymore because we've denied access to that area now. So let's just go back to the home page, and you can see that we've also been denied there as well, because we've got the global deny defined. So what's important to understand here is that we can set out a range of different commands, and Nginx will run or will look or access, or what's the right word here? Nginx will process those commands in order, in sequence. So from the top to the bottom. Okay, so I'm trying to elaborate there unnecessarily. Okay, so Nginx here is going to process the sequence of IP address restrictions that we define from top to bottom. Okay, so this one can be the bottom command. So what we can now say is say allow. So we can define an IP address that we want to allow. And first of all, this directive will be assessed if it's true. If the IP address matches in this case, then we will allow, and then anything else will be denied. So let's go ahead and try this out. You can see that we're going to need a semicolon, so don't forget that. So let's go ahead, and I'm going to reload again and just refresh. And notice that we still have a forbidden. So what's happening here? So remember, we're working locally here and inside of our container. Now, the best thing to do here, if you are working locally, you want to try this out. If you just have a look at the logs here in the Nginx container, it does give you some information about where the request is coming from. So our host is 127.0.0.1. That's on our server. And this looks like the IP address that we're utilizing, 127.24.0.1. And you can see that it's telling us that we've got the forbidden. So let's go ahead and just change this. Now, this isn't going to work straight off. So let me just change that. I'm going to go back to my container and reload to reload the configuration. If I refresh, oh, actually, in fact, it does work. Okay, so there we go. So we can see how to potentially access our IP address just locally, just to test this out. And you can now see I have access to the locations where I didn't before. So here we can see the two directives. Okay, so if, for example, let's just try that. So let's just go for deny all here, right? So we're going to move deny all up the top and then the allow below. So we know this allow will allow us, and deny here is just denying everyone. So this is where we need to experiment and understand the behavior, because like I said previously, the rules here are processed in sequence from top to bottom. So the question is, will it process this first and then ignore this, or will it process this first and ignore everything else? That's really the question at this point, right? So let's go ahead and reload, and I'll go ahead and refresh, and it looks like we are forbidden. So we can say here the rules are, if we deny all, then the other commands will not get read. Apologies, I mean the other IP address directives will be ignored. But okay, so let's go ahead. We know this is the IP address. So let's put the IP address here on the deny first. So first of all, we're going to deny this IP address, and then we're going to allow it. So this is another behavioral aspect to have a look at. So we're going to reload. I'm going to go ahead and refresh, and you can still see that that is the case. So we still have read the deny. We deny the IP address, and then we still continue moving on to the other directives here, but we ignore all the other IP address directives. So here we're using single IP addresses. So we're not limited to single IP addresses. We've seen that we can use the deny all or maybe allow all. Obviously, we don't need allow all. That's the default setting. So in addition to this, we can also use address ranges. So here we need to understand a little bit more about networking, of course, but we can have address ranges that we can apply this to. And in addition to that, we can also use IP address 4 and IP address 6. So let's take a look at this, utilizing this actually in a location. So we can specify allow. So we're going to go for deny all here. And then we're going to move our IP address. Let's move this across. So this is in the server block. And then let's go for our test area here. So let's just have an allow. So let's see if, in this case, let's check to see if the IP address in the server block is read, and then let's see if it then ignores all the other IP directives here inside of the actual locations. That would be interesting. Right, so one would expect it will do. So let's go ahead and reload, and we're going to refresh, and you can see the test is now actually being allowed. So if we go in here, So we go here, you can see that the main page is forbidden. So this is in our server block, we have deny all. So in this scenario, any location that hasn't then been assigned to any other additional IP allow deny directives, you can see that it will apply the deny all. However, in this case, we have allowed our IP address in this location here. So we've made a very specific request or we've made a very specific configuration for this location. That's probably better. So therefore, you can see that in actual fact, the deny all is actually overridden. In this case, then the location block takes precedence and the configuration is then applied. So it's well worth playing with this and trying these different combinations out to see for yourself how things react, because you won't probably find any documentation on this. And this is something that you'd need to try for yourself and practice in order for you to gain that understanding and knowledge, for you to then start to configure your IP address restrictions for your configuration. Okay, so we have the allow here in the location block. So we've learned now how we can apply the IP directives here, allow, deny inside of the different locations, as well as the server block. Something that you may have highlighted from this tutorial is that there is a need for you to understand IP addresses, IP address version 4 and 6. And then to move a little bit further into IP addresses, to think about subnetting. If you are moving into this space, it'd be well worth you understanding more about the general dynamics of an IP address, the construct of an IP address, and subnetting. Okay, so that was about 5 pieces of information in way too much time. I do apologize. Hopefully all this embellishment is helping you understand these concepts in a little bit of a deeper way. I do try and challenge you, give you some directions and pointers towards other subjects and topics. Hopefully that is useful. If you like it, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.